Good afternoon to everybody. Good afternoon, all of you. Before I say anything, I want all of you to close your eyes. I want all of you to close your eyes and forget everything that you're thinking about and just stay calm. Imagine you're traveling in a bicycle across Bangalore. You're driving across the busy streets of Bangalore. There's a lot of commotion and pollution around you. It's buzzing with cars. And you ride across a place where you see people running behind a lorry to fetch a drum of water. You hear all the quarrel. You also ride across a place where you see kids rag picking. And among those kids, there are a few kids who are playing with a new school bag that they have found from the rubbish. You also see people walking with their face covered across a lake because the smell is repulsive. And a lot of people are complaining about how the government is doing nothing, the BBMP is doing nothing. And then there are some people who are saying that we are just common people and we can do nothing about it. On that note, I want all of you to open your eyes. Good afternoon again. My name is Vibish Kashyap, and I would like to call myself as someone who is disturbed by all the problems around us, but more disturbed by all of our reaction towards it. I studied in TVS Academy, Hosur, and my school played a great role to whatever I am today. We learned to become empathetic leaders and to be aware of all the problems in the environment. Thanks to all the community development activities that we were a part of, that has made me inculcate a lot of values like responsibility, environmental awareness, and whatnot. Okay, so I would like to tell you about one experience about what I did when I was in TVS. It isn't very different for a TVS school kid to go on a weekend and to spend their weekend doing community cleaning. That's what I did too when I gathered a group of friends of mine to go and clean up a community park. What used to be a picturesque and a beautiful place had become a dump yard, and people did nothing about it. The mess really bothered me, and I wanted to do something about it, and that's when I called my friends, and we went to that park and we started cleaning. We went there for 2 days and we started cleaning, and at the end of day two, nothing really seemed different. Our hearts sunk and we were about to give up just when people who saw us cleaning started volunteering to help us. That's when we realized that when we do something, it really inspires people to do something that they would want to, make a difference to. They expected someone to come and start something. So when other people came and joined us, we started believing that anyone can make a difference. And then when all of us were doing things together, the place did seem different. This was the first time I realized that a small sense of civic sense and responsibility can make a big difference. I was 13 when ReapBenefit had come to our school. ReapBenefit is an organization which works in Bangalore, and they work with the youth to, you know, make them solve ninjas, and to, you know, make youth to come and solve environmental and social problems around. So I started working with ReapBenefit. My school had already motivated me enough to do something for the community, but then with ReapBenefit, I learned methodical ways of solving a problem. The one method that we learned was the DIS method of solving the problem. DIS method of solving a problem is DISS, which stands for Discover, Investigate, Solve, and Share. Where D, discover, means that you discover a problem and you understand the root causes about it. And then investigate. You investigate about how the problem has an effect on all the different stakeholders. And then you solve the problem in the most sustainable way. And the solution should be in such a way that solution at one place does not become problem in the other place. And then you share the outcome, and then you share the entire process so that when you share it to other people, the process becomes more effective. with ReapBenefit and this, I started working in a lot of projects in my school which involved working for waste management and water conservation. I built various things like, you know, a biosand water filter and drip irrigation using plastic bottles and etc. That's when I got a chance to become the ambassador for Hindustan Unilever's Project Sunlight, which was aimed at bringing about clean and good sanitary practices across India. So I got an opportunity to be a part of the campaign in newspapers and TV news channels, and I saw that as a platform to talk about whatever I felt like. I also won a grant of 5 lakhs rupees for a proposal submitted to work in to work for sanitation facilities in schools in Hosur. This proposal was written by my principal, who also shared the dream of equal sanitary facilities to all the children like me. I was so happy that I was not only working for my dream, but also for the dream of my teacher and also many other people in this world. There have been many instances where we have been to government schools and started working with kids, and when we talk with them, we have heard stories when they have told how tough of a life it was to live without proper toilets and proper sanitary facilities. That's when we decided that sanitation needs to be worked on and has to be improved in all the schools. So we started Project Hosur Sanitation, and the first thing was a list of schools were made to go and work on, and then a big team of my school juniors and the government school students worked together to understand what were the different problems that people actually wanted to solve. And then there was a lot of dialogue happening, and problems included open urinals and which have no privacy and which was stinking of bad odor, and people wanted to work on it. So that's when, you know, we started to think about solutions for open urinals and many other problems, which included, you know, no hand washing units, unclean tanks, etc. So to address all these problems, steps were taken, and the first step that we took towards implementing in the schools was to implement waterless urinals. Waterless urinals are a simple and a sustainable solutions which tackles both the problem of improper sanitation at the same time taking care of water. Every time when you flush urine with 2 or 3 liters of water, so we wanted to save that water and divert it. So that's how we came up with the idea of waterless urinals. Let me tell you about how the waterless urinal actually works. Waterless urinals are built using 20 liter water cans with a hole made, and then how can a urinal be possibly waterless? We used ping pong balls to block the outlet of the urinal and the inlet of the drain so that the smell was entirely blocked. This saves so much of water which was used to flush water. So waterless urinals were starting to build, implemented in all the different schools. And we did not stop with waterless urinals. Several other implementations were made in government schools, which included, you know, grey water harvesting units, which were built with plastic water cans again, and the hand washing units where all the water used for hand washing can be diverted and can be reused. And then compost pits were made. Compost pits were used to, you know, recycle all the wet waste generated in schools. And rainwater harvesting pits were made to collect all the water that collects on the terrace, and then they were sent through pipes to the pits so that rainwater was also used. This entire process was happening in all the schools around Hosur. But one most important thing is all the challenges that we had to face throughout this entire process. Challenges included when me and my school juniors from a private school went to a different school to work, we were completely ambiguous about whether people there were understanding all these things and whether they actually felt the necessity of all of us doing this. That's when we wanted to do something to win their trust. So we started sharing success stories about waterless urinals in other places in different schools, and we provided with them quantitative data of how much a simple implementation like a waterless urinals can divert so much of water. And in the present day world with so much of problems, and cities like Chennai and Bangalore in the verge of running out of water, how much of water is an important thing. And we try to tell them all this. And I was extremely overwhelmed when once I heard that students whom I had worked with and our school juniors had worked with started going to other schools where sanitation facilities was not proper, and they themselves started building waterless urinals without any of us being there. I'm very proud to say that now we've actually lost count of the number of waterless urinals because this movement has started to spread. But effectively, Project Hosur Sanitation is a success story in more than 15 schools, and more than 300 waterless urinals have been implemented. And what have I learned through this entire process? All that I have realized that all that it requires is a simple intent to do something different and a motive to do something good for the society. But it does not stop with the motive or the intent. When we come up with solutions to do something for the society, solutions should of course be sustainable, and at the same time all the solutions that we are looking at needs to be local. Where there are many of us who are working for environmental problems these days, but the goal lies in all of our problems, all of the solutions that we have for problems need to align. And when we are thinking about environmental problems, solutions for environmental problems needs to be brought only after considering society and environment. Now, I again request all of you to close your eyes. I want all of you to again take your bicycle and go around Bangalore. This time, you see people who were fighting for water earlier are sitting there and having discussions about how they can do effective water management in their communities. And then you see people who are carpooling. You also see people pulling up their socks and going into lakes and troughs, which are dump yards, and taking initiatives to make something different. You are extremely contented because now there is no blame game happening and no one is waiting for no one else to do something different. Everyone is becoming change maker and everyone is taking a step forward. You are extremely contented. But are you going to stop with being content, or are you going to become a leader too? Open your eyes. On that note, thank you.